Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome back to Casey and Marty Plays. Right now, Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. It's me, Casey, joined by Marty Sliva.
Hello everyone.
And this is our finale, the final episode in the series of Metal Gear games. It's been a long road to get here, but we have arrived.
We have arrived. This is our Revengeance finale. I'm trying to see. I want to see how long it's been. Was it April? Is that what? I feel like I looked this up recently and that we started this in April.
Like we started the first Metal Gear Solid in April, you're saying?
Yeah, because it's probably earlier than April, because I feel like we started Dead Space at the end of at the end of 2021 and then finished it in like January or February. I don't know how anything works.
The Dead Space remake is about to be out soon. That might be something we have to mess around with.
I mean, like the timing on it is like impeccable. If we would have planned it, we literally could have started the Dead Space remake next week.
Oh yeah, we probably could have.
I mean, chat, what are we?
I mean, they did pay money for the Half-Life thing.
They did pay money, but it's not like Half-Life's gonna go anywhere. And yeah, we know Dead Space 1 isn't the longest game in the world.
And maybe we don't have to play through the whole thing.
Or maybe it's too scary and we can't.
I mean, it's too scary with the new engine, I suppose.
Yeah, how do you feel? Well, this is an impromptu. No decisions are being made. Ultimately, probably Nick has to make that decision, if I'm being honest. If we would take a Half-Life detour and play through Dead Space remake,
TJ Carr also makes a good point. Dead Space also isn't going anywhere. Maybe
that is also true. But we could strike while the iron's hot. Speaking of hot irons, look at this motorcycle.
Imagine you're like just on the highway and you see a freaking cyborg on a Harley Davidson driving in the center of the road, like not even in a lane.
I don't like this though, because it's like a small horse riding a bigger horse. Like, this makes me uncomfortable.
Everything okay on your side?
I am out of Colorado airspace and nothing on the radar.
Good. I'm almost there.
Oh yeah, he's supposed. I guess you're gonna have to do a quick recap, but I do remember that they're trying to get to something that moves very fast.
Oh yeah, well, I would love to do a recap. I don't know the story of this game well. Where were we? We were trying to get to, it's like a rural ass place, like Denver or something. Was that where we were going? Let me see.
Oh boy.
We were in Pakistan last time. Oh, this is Pakistan. Never mind. We're in Pakistan. Hey guys, welcome.
That's not our dog, is it?
He better not have taken our dog and made him a meanie. Oh, TJ Carr says we're in Colorado. That is way different than Pakistan.
Analyzed his words and actions.
That is our dog.
Unable to ascertain his motivation.
Fancy meeting you here. You knew I'd come. I suppose I should thank you for not killing everyone at the launch site.
It's very nice.
Well, not if you say it like that. For a hired killer, you're not very good at your job. The war is the big payoff. Right. Big raises all around once World Marshal gets all those contracts.
I'm not talking about money, Jack. I'm talking ideals.
Excuse me?
Forget it. We've both heard enough speeches about higher causes by now.
Biden definitely has.
History will decide who's right.
We destroyed a PMC in Denver. There's trouble in Pakistan, so I think we're trying to get back to Pakistan quickly on our motorcycle.
But I remember he needed to get somewhere that had some device that can fly like Mach 23.
Oh, yeah, that was it. It was like, we'll get there in like 45 minutes.
Yeah, like no one could think of this thing that could solve their problem until someone did. And it's like, oh, yeah, we'll just go get that thing.
I don't care who thinks
but I don't know what that thing is.
I've got cause enough for killing you. Huh? Oh, good.
I like that their relationship, they're kind of like Spider-Man and Venom, where they're like uneasy. They're not like friends, but like,
there's a mutual they
like fight each
there.
Other. Yeah, there's kind of like a Goku-Vegeta thing going on.
Like they respect one another's like ability.
Don't interfere.
Yeah. And they show that respect by just beating the shit out of each other in the middle of Denver.
Because the other one would have it no other way.
This is
between us.
King Dead said, go to the Denver airport and the demon horse statue. I love the Denver airport. What a scary place.
And it ends here. Okay. Let's dance!
It's weird that Raiden covers the top of his face and this dude covers his, like, mouth. Like, he's like Hannibal Lecter getting ready to munch on some people.
Defeat Samuel.
This is also, this is really, like, just tossing you in the deep end. Of like, oh, hey,
shit.
Remember last
week? I still
week?
Got the Psy.
Oh no!
Yeah, fudge that. All right, I gotta remember.
Can you restart the chapter and choose your?
I wonder. Can I continue from the last checkpoint?
No checkpoint.
I mean, the game did kind of just start at the beginning of the cutscene and not like in the.
Yeah. How do we get rid of the Psy, Chad? Wait,
is there
an easy way to get rid
can,
of the Psy?
Like, change my weapon. I can pause.
You could press left or right to change the weapon. Are you
get out of here?
Kidding us?
Why do I keep giving myself weird handicaps? Oh shit! It's right here. Oh. It was right here the whole.
Are we assholes? Also, this isn't on us. This is on everyone. This is on everyone. When we were complaining about this stuff last time, to be like, "Hey, dummies, open up your menu." Also, it seems weirdly antithetical to like everything Metal Gear is about to be like, no, you made the choice at the beginning of the chapter, you have to stick with it. No, Naka Jackson, we didn't know, no one told us.
Ouch.
We're back, everything's fine. Hijikara says this game needs a handicap versus KC. See? I like that. Casey was saying before we went live that when he played this game originally, he remembers it because he did finish this game. You said when it came out or sometime after?
I don't know if it was when it came out, but probably sometime afterwards.
Around then.
Yeah.
He remembers it being a lot harder. So we don't know. Maybe he's just gotten better.
I don't have healing stuff.
No, that's bad. If we die, will it give us more healies? Chat, is there a menu we can go to make more healies?
No, Chat, I just gotta get good as well.
You might not need them, but there are healing packs in the wooden crates around this area. Thank you, Dak and Jaxter.
Gotcha. Alright, I gotta adjust after the week or so of not playing this game, though. So
yeah, oh, you still got Psy as well.
You're right. I do.
Yeah, I was saying that earlier. It's always tough to pick up a game after a week, and this is a particularly intense moment to have to pick it up.
He attacks several times.
Yeah.
He has his, Gotta watch that.
It doesn't seem like he has a rhythm, because this battle obviously is bringing shades of Sekiro.
Right.
But I don't think there's like the rhythm at play. Jesus.
Oh, that second swing
is, yeah,
it's really fast. Keep missing that fourth string. Oh my god, okay, he covered that distance real quick.
Music in this game is so funny. Oh. Oh, hell yeah.
Like, I don't know how many times I swung at the square. They didn't give it to me until, like, that final time. Oh, he don't give a damn. He's like, I'll fight you without
sword. You got a med pack. I don't know where that came from. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, don't touch it. It's mine now.
I'll
give you that.
Burned. That was good. Okay, that was good.
Shoot.
Oh, he looked a little dazed. Where were these fucking crates? I heard so many rumors about.
I
Green Venice, what's up, says the final boss of this game is my objective favorite boss in any game. Hell yeah. That's good. It's also a good example of Kojima-adjacent things being weirdly prescient. Oh! he almost nipped you while you were aiming down the rocket launcher.
He's like, oh, he's open. What the fuck is that?
Uh-oh. Command now!
I don't know what he did. Oh,
what
shit!
What are you, oh! Oh no!
Hello. Now we're
talking. Oh, the crates are super scattered about the area. You really need to hunt for them. Okay, we'll see. We're doing good. Reclaim. Yes. To most of that, except for you calling it something stupid, because it's fucking great. I will accept no negativity for this game. Except all the negativity we've leveled at the game.
I think I see some of these crates out in the distance.
Oh, shit!
Oh, Jesus.
He be flying.
Yeah, they said there's some on the other side of the highway.
I shouldn't have ran. That was a problem.
Yeah. Maybe try to scour the place for them.
Yeah, like earlier start, on.
Because he's
yeah.
less. Yeah, he's less aggressive. And yeah, I'm mentioning, as everyone can see, we are past the 70% mark for Adventurers Live, which is very exciting. That is going to be our new Friday stream in the Halo Infinite spot. So, you know, late Friday afternoon, early Friday evening, and it's going to be Jack, Casey, Amy, and Jesse playing through Dungeons & Dragons video games. Think of it as like a Otherworld, an Elseworld version of Adventurous Night. So we'll be playing those games, spoofing, goofing. So yeah, those will probably start sometime in February, I imagine.
I just missed. I just wholesale missed.
I'm glad that he gave you full time to just reload your rocket launcher. That was kind of him.
These like fences in the background I'm looking at is what I was thinking were the crates, but they're
not. Oh, I think people said they're all the way on the other side of the highway. Man, he does not. He punishes you for trying to run away.
As he should. It's a coward's way.
9 Seed says a crate with a healing item is next to the boulder behind where Sam starts.
If only I can remember where Sam starts.
Oh, yeah, you were. I think that's a crate, right?
This looks like a crate.
Oh, no. Oh, also, I think you still get. Do you have your shitty sigh? Shitty sigh?
I do have the sigh, but it was actually helping me out.
Okay. Yeah, not shitty anymore.
Okay, just kick you back a little bit.
That might be a crate also on the far left. Or it's just like a square in the distance. Esperon says, so would Diablo qualify for the new D&D streams? Well, I think you guys are starting out with something called Demio.
Yeah. That one is very, like, role-playing miniature looking.
Okay. George Lucas said they mentioned Side Quest 2, Episode 1 has been filmed. Yeah, and Jack in the last stream said that Episode 2 is being filmed tomorrow.
Nice.
And if you are in the Discord and in early access, you can see a teaser thumbnail that might give you a clue as to some of the folks who will be returning. Amy says, Lord help my Path of Exile shill ass if I had to play Diablo. Isn't Diablo? Don't people like Diablo? Devil? I played those games.
But it's I think it's a direct competitor to Path of Exile.
Oh, yeah.
Used to work on.
Man, yeah, he's doing these like fucking lightning strikes. That's good, he didn't take any damage.
Okay, that was a miss.
Good, you got him down to quarter health. Oh, you got an anger mode. Hell yeah, 70%.
Oh, that's bigger. Whoa.
Whoa! Cut those rocks! Get those rocks out of here!
I thought he was coming, not rocks.
He's probably coming after the rocks. If I were him, I would like pocket sand. Throw the rocks and then you run after him. Pocket sand! Oh, and there's, is that another box?
Might be.
Okay. Oh!
Yep.
Niblets! Oh, we got this. I don't want to get too cocky, but I think we got this. Ooh. Oh no.
Oh, I tried to run in.
Pocket sand.
Why do you
he's being super
now?
Defensive now. He's really battening down the hatches at 13%.
Yeah, he's just backing up. Oh, nice. Nice. He caught me slipping.
John Lee says, how many D&D type games has Jack played, do you reckon? Like video games. I don't know. I know he said he's learning with some friends Pathfinder, which is exciting. I'll be honest, I don't know. I thought Pathfinder was just like a genre of D&D, but apparently it's like a D&D competitor or something. No.
Hard miss.
Oh my god, one of these has to cut his arm! Okay, I take back that whole thing about how they're just like buds that don't hurt each other. Goku would never stab Vegeta in the chest.
I mean, they made a gentleman's agreement that somebody had to die after this.
George Lucas, Pathfinder is not a video game. Jack is learning how to play Pathfinder like a Pathfinder.
Yeah, it's like a different role-playing rule set or something.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't wink at my dog. You're not allowed.
So I know there's DLC where you play as Sam, but I don't know if it's...
He is dead.
Well, it's probably before this, yeah. Dog answered my question there.
Was this outcome necessary?
Great question.
Is any of this necessary?
Inconclusive.
I guess even AIs don't know everything.
It is likely no single correct answer exists. Additionally, human conflict stems from opposing ideals and societal norms. I was not programmed with these guidelines.
I feel bad with this dog because, like, Raiden, like, forced it to become, like, sentient, and now it's, like, having to deal with, like, all of society's problems.
How the world works. Like, I have no such societal norms. I'm a sicko.
He's like Marvin in Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. He just becomes depressed because he has to think about humans.
Who's his daddy?
I will retain it in memory of Sam.
Thank you, dog. I don't know who his dad is.
Was his dad also a cyborg?
Was his dad Cyborg Ninja from Metal Gear? Sound off in the comments below. I don't think so. Ooh, that was cool.
Sword draw where he fires it out of the freaking holster is still super
fucking
dope.
Sick. It reminds me of the mechanical shit on the what do they call the Attack on Titan like suits and
the 3D maneuvering gear.
Yeah. Peace out. you may have died, but we got to be. Sam's dad was killed by the cartel, who Sam took down single-handedly in revenge. Good on Sam.
Single-handedly? Like, after he became a cyborg, or, like, as a young...
As, like, a child?
Yeah, like, a young Jetstream cyborg.
Was his dad also named Jetstream?
Jetstream Johnny Jr.
Jetstream? Jetstream Jr. what else do we get? Foxblade? Oh, we still have enough for this.
What? That thing is 200,000.
200,000? When I see a bunch of zeros, I have a very hard time immediately parsing how many zeros it is. Is there like a... Like, is this like an actual disability I have where if I go in... If someone asked me how many seats are in this movie theater, if I was in an empty theater, and someone said how many seats are in this theater, there's like a possibility I would be like thousands off the correct answer. Like, I have no perception of like... How many jelly beans are in this jar? Like, I might guess like 7,000, and they'd be like, it's 115. Like, what? Like, but in my mind, I was like, I don't know, it looked like 7,000. Whatever that is, I have that.
Yeah, I don't
number
know
blindness.
If that's a disability, and just...
Maybe I just need to take a second to think before I talk.
Yeah, like, you just... I don't think this guy was paying attention to what we just asked him.
How much does this pig weigh? 15 pounds. This is a large pig, sir. Do you want another guess?
Like, do you want to look at the pig first before you...
No, it's a little guy, I'm sure.
I don't know why this scene where this man eats this pizza is is stuck in my brain.
It's... So him eating the pizza was so unappetizing while reading his fucking Shonen Jump. And...
Like, there's nothing to read. Like, he's literally just looking at pictures of anime girls. There are no
pizza.
There's hardly any text on there.
Are you Mr. Raiden, sir?
Oh my God!
Mike's wearing sunglasses.
How do you get this job?
Nepotism. He's a nepo baby. His dad's probably head of security.
You've arrived.
Over here.
Did the dog like jump the fence? Because Raiden just opened
it. Who is
it?
Look who it is.
Is that who I think it is? Hi there, and she's stranger. Somehow got a hold of her mom's shirt.
Aww, who's your little friend?
So wait, how many years after four is this?
This seems several. Like she seems
like a couple years older.
12 now, probably. I think it's supposed to be like four or 5 years after. 4 years.
Why you play him like that?
I guess we don't really have time.
He got really angry.
Not really. he goes into this crazy mode.
He was gonna hurt somebody. Jeez. He's gonna run.
Alex English said grows a growth spurt when you don't have to live in a fucking airplane anymore.
So exactly what kind of
George Lucas says she looks like a Final Fantasy character. She looks like all the gas station attendants in Final Fantasy 15.
Cindy? Yeah, I've seen that character.
Yeah. That's the one's older and more sexualized, but it seems like they're from the same cloth.
Yeah, since Kojima's not involved in this, it seems like Platinum was able to make it make sense.
A little bit.
It uses a hybrid lace ramjet engine I designed.
How crazy is it? That if you, in a vacuum, Platinum games are fucking out of control wild. But when, like, compared to Kojima, they're like, Platinums are all, like, conservative, buttoned up. This is a family video game, sir.
Like, they go nuts within the confines of, like, what makes sense for the thing. Kojima just goes nuts.
Yeah.
They're like, oh, if we're going to make a game about a cybernetic ninja, then he should be able to body slam an airplane.
Yeah.
Why not? Like Kojima says, if I'm going to make a video game, I'm going to make it read to you. It's going to make it read your memory card and hack into your family's computer.
Casey says that she still wear ill-fitting boots. Well, she's grown, so maybe she fits in the boots.
Yeah, it's the same boots, but she's had bigger feet now.
Yeah, it could be a problem, though. Maybe they're ill-fitting the other way, where, like, she's gotten too big for them.
She can't take them off.
Yeah.
They're just her feet now.
She's got to sleep in those boots.
I'm curious if any of the stuff he's looking at in that book exists.
Is real?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That man should be fired.
This one's got boobs. Yeah, I wonder, because this was I wouldn't be surprised if Konami is also like a manga publisher in Japan. Like, I know Bandai and Square all publish like manga and anime and stuff. So maybe that was some of those weirdo characters.
So that little space shuttle looking thing was the thing we were rushing to get to. They didn't even let us really see it in action.
Yeah, it feels like we should have been like, what is it like inside that thing, right? Yeah. Like, you're going very fast.
Or maybe give us a cutscene where it's just going Mach 1000.
Yeah, yeah. Like, they could have done a bunch of shots of, like, famous landmarks, and then you see the thing jet across the sky of, like, the Statue of Liberty and the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah.
I'm
headed in.
Right, I'm going to write a strongly worded letter to Kamiya. Kamiya and Kojima. I'm going to CC both of them.
And then Kamiya will block you.
Kamiya will block me. And Kojima will give me his thoughts on the hit film Babylon.
Is that before or after he takes your soul?
Please, just step inside this machine.
Like, I'll address all your concerns after the machining. I want to try out this pincer blade. Hello, boys. Dude, that was really slow. Like, is that all that's doing? That one big swing? Okay. Oh. Super dramatic.
Jumbly said, Sunny's in your codec now, and you can call her anytime.
Question, why would I want
to? And if we call her, well, we'll do it after we finish killing folks. We'll call Sunny, and apparently if we call her once or twice, she'll talk about Otacon. Otacon.
Oh, she'll let us know what he's up to?
Is that Sunny?
Their exit codes show up as unaffiliated.
Wait, Marshall has the security contract for the space.
Fucking Courtney. I don't want to talk to Courtney. I care about you.
I keep forgetting she's a character here. I don't know what she does.
If we ranked every single person you can call in every Metal Gear game, legitimately Courtney might be at the bottom. Give me one. Chat, even folks who've played this game a bunch, give me one fact about Courtney. Other than she is blonde and has glasses.
They've got this nice big foreign threat all cooked up and ready to serve. The media and the public won't be able to resist. Remember WMDs in Iraq?
I do.
Jumbly Wombly says she loves cooking?
Everyone loves cooking. What are you talking about? Sunny loves cooking. She made eggs. You're thinking of Sunny.
Dead, most likely. Or brain-jacked.
Reclaimed Destin said she's got a blue shirt! They
never
Yeah?
Is that blue or is that like codec shading? It might be white.
That could be codec shading. You might be wrong. Yeah. Because she would probably wear a white shirt to work, right? Fancy. I shouldn't have asked for another fact because everyone's just talking about their boobs now. Good idea. I brought that out. Like, I gotta allow them through because I dug that fucking
thing. TJ Carr says it's a gold shirt. I see what you did there.
What does that mean?
Remember when
the blue gold? Gold. You want to call Sunny? See if we can get some Sunny, sure. Some Sunny facts.
How was the ride?
Jesus, Sunny, she answered fine, extremely thanks. Quickly.
Yeah, she has nothing else to do right now.
Smoothest ride ever. You sure that thing's really airworthy?
Well, what do you expect? You're traveling at a few dozen times the speed of sound. I mean, she operates well within all the projected margins of safety. So, yes. We'll have to work on the turbulence levels a bit before we can take tourists on it. But Come on, you really can't complain.
So it's meant mainly for cargo at the moment?
Mm-hmm. We got a contract with COTS, NASA's Commercial Orbital Transportation Services. Mostly handling space deliveries, that kind of thing. We also joined the C3PO, the Commercial Crew and
That's
Cargo
already a thing.
Program Office.
You can't do that. That's already a man in another story.
So soon we'll have private spacecraft bringing crew to the International
Space
Station.
It's a massive acronym.
Wild times we're living in.
Well, the space race has been over for decades now. It's no longer something countries engage in for vanity's sake. Still, lots of people are starting to see the industrial value of zero-gravity experiments. Plus, the costs are getting lower and lower with each passing year, to the point where we'll have a serious space tourism industry before long.
Yeah, I heard about this. Kojima predicting the future now. Like,
but we're still not going any.
I feel like this is sponsored. This is like sponsored content by NASA. Like, they should have to be like hashtag ad sponsor.
Not ours, though. I'm just hoping we can get to Jupiter while Hal's still alive.
Jupiter, huh? Wow, that's pretty far.
Oh, hey, how did Earth look from up there?
I can't even put it into words.
Were you like in space?
I'm assuming. Yeah, I'm assuming that's how you can move that fast as you go to like low Earth.
Yeah, I guess you weren't just like, oh, I'm 1,000 feet up. Again, that, I mean, that had to be. I'm sure that's a budget thing, but like that'd have been nice to see, like in a 30-second montage.
Yep. Well, good luck, Jack. Raiden.
Thanks, honey.
So like call her right back, or she did mention that a little bit.
We try. Georgia says, "Is Hal a reference to 2001: A Space Odyssey?" Maybe. Like, there's really no other famous Hals. So, and Kojima definitely seems like a dude who
would watch and love that movie.
Yeah.
Like that movie shaped my existence.
Yeah.
Said Kojima.
I don't know what Emmerich is. Maybe a reference to Roland Emmerich, his favorite director of Independence Day and 2012 and Moonfall. No. I know we know Hal is Otacon. We're wondering if when he originally named Otacon Hal, if it was a reference to 2001.
Raiden, there is no time to worry about the soldiers.
Oh.
Get to the control tower.
I never put that. Two and two together, Jack and Daxter. Jack and Daxter. I'm just gonna call you Jack and Daxter. It's fine. But Snake's real name is David. Solid Snake's like actual name is David, and Hal.
Oh,
David's
and
the
Hal.
Main character
yeah.
of 2001, and Hal's the robot.
I forgot to do the second part of that stealth attack. Like, he just died real basic,
really painfully. Also, I played more High Rush.
Yeah, I finished the first chapter of that earlier today.
I realized the way I was mis-explaining it last night, and what I meant was the reason to me it feels more forgiving is because yeah, there's a beat, but your instrument you almost start a beat on your first attack. If that makes that's the thing I think I was trying to say is where like when you first attack you can use that to start an ongoing beat.
Yeah.
If that makes sense. Like, what did you think of the first chapter?
I liked it. The combat is they are doing a very specific thing. So
yeah,
it's not like oh if you love action games that look like that you'll fit right in. It's doing something. That you'll need to kind of play the game at its own pace, like what it's asking you to do.
Yeah.
So I'm still getting used to that because, you know, I have a lot of, muscle memory for games like this where you know.
Yeah.
It's more, let me watch what the enemy does and then react accordingly.
Where do you stand on, like, rhythm games?
Outside of like the Rock Bands and
yeah,
like Just Dance, which like my family likes a whole lot.
Sure.
I've not messed with them like any like those theater rhythm games that we were talking about on my podcast not too long ago, where you're like using your hands to do the rhythm stuff. Like I've not ever tried or had much of an interest in that.
You ever have you played like Beat Saber or anything like that?
No.
Okay.
Where's Mango?
Oh, Jesse, I totally missed that. Thank you so much for raiding. Party 7.
Thank you.
Jesse, hello, Jesse. So you finished the first, you finished like the tutorial thing with the boss with the Nine Inch Nails thing?
Yeah, like the big boss?
Yeah, like did you get to the apartment?
Yes.
Like the home base thing? Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm curious to play more of it to see like how it evolves, like what, I'm assuming it's relatively short, it's probably like 6 hours or something. I don't know, I'm just really happy of a thing that we didn't know existed that suddenly was just here.
Yeah,
if you have Game Pass,
really
you can
cool,
just download obviously. It. Yeah.
So this is for charging, that's what this is all about. And this just seems to shield break.
Oh, Chun-Li Wanmi said a cutscene's coming soon, try to call Sunny. Can we call Sunny in the middle of battle?
Is that what they
Paul
want to
Saez
do?
Says it's almost now? Jesse's birthday, I heard.
Oh, Jesse's
Jesse, is that almost your birthday? Is that a rumor? Is that the truth or is that a lie?
That's a lie.
It's is it a lie?
Yeah, Jesse's birthday was the stream we did on Monday.
Jesse! Did you lie? Well, I guess it wasn't technically Jesse. Who lied? Paul Saez lied. Okay, before you kill the last guy, try to call. Can you call her?
Let's see.
You designed that thing too, Sonny?
Uh-oh. We just have a normal conversation.
Yep, she pretty much did it by herself.
I think I may be missing something here.
We used a genetic algorithm to make it. Ever hear of that? They use it to build the cars for bullet trains and stuff. Basically, we start by creating a few different models of aircraft. The data for each design is treated as the genes for a new aircraft. They all get crossbred with each other in virtual space. Eventually, you come up with offspring that exhibit genes from each original design.
Offspring?
You know, children.
Like the band?
Each child then can
pretty fly for a white guy.
Remember, I don't have a ethnicity.
And pass on their genes, creating the next generation of aircraft. You get this sort of gene-based evolution across generations, like animals in real life.
I'm having a hard time imagining aircraft having kids like that.
I'm now imagining conservatives getting mad at Pretty Fly for a White Guy and like starting like a hashtag all guys can be fly.
Did you see on Twitter someone who crap for A&W Root Beer, one of the brand dudes, put up a post mocking the M&M's situation where they said because of the polarizing nature of their latest candy thing, they're going with a human, whatever. The A&W Root Beer mascot apparently is a bear that has been pantsless since like the 60s. And they he put pants on the bear because they said a bear with no pants can be polarizing. And Fox Business News covered it as if it was real. It was like, oh, look what the woke people have done. They just canceled the bear. And it's like, they were like, really like, oh, it's so ridiculous. Meanwhile, it was conservatives who were upset over the M&M thing. It's amazingly insane how they can just, like, the echo chamber is like in a closed toilet. Like, I don't understand what in their brains are doing.
That echo chamber is a porta potty.
Like, oh my God. Like, it breaks my brain to think that they actually don't understand what they're doing. They must know, right?
I think the people reporting on it know, and I think there's a lot of people who just gobble up, just pigs at the trough. Yes, their minds are full of brain worms. Yeah. Also, that Eminem thing has to be a lead up to a Super Bowl ad, right? That's what that is. Like, that wasn't a real... My gut says that it wasn't a real... Like, that whole statement thing is going to... There's going to be a
like
Super Bowl
going
ad
to be like, F y'all.
With Maya Rudolph and two M&Ms are, like, going to fuck during the Super Bowl. Like, I genuinely think... I put my money down. I went all in Crab Feeder, and that was bad. I went all in James Cameron, and that was good. And so my next all in is going to be that there will be a Super Bowl ad with two M&Ms. Fuck.
I like the idea that it's a... A ploy.
Like a troll?
Yeah. I'm not sure I like the idea about the M&M's fucking
Okay, well, you haven't seen it yet, so don't kink shame.
My question is, do you think Maya Rudolph would let an M&M go down on her?
Depends which one. Not the dopey peanut one.
the yellow one's got no swag. Maya Rudolph would never.
I bought popcorn from Maya Rudolph at an early screening of Paul Thomas Anderson's The Master in San Francisco at the Castro Theater. She is, I don't know if they're married, but they're longtime partners and like they have a bunch of kids together. To the director Paul Thomas Anderson, who directed like Magnolia and There Will Be Blood and Licorice Pizza. But he debuted his movie at the time, The Master, and she was there super pregnant, like selling t-shirts and popcorn and stuff.
That's really funny.
So yeah.
Like just being supportive.
Just being supportive, yeah, which I found really nice.
I'm not done. Get these legs.
Apparently the yellow M&M is voiced by J.K. Simmons, so I retract my statement.
I never knew J.K. that. Simmons, like,
every once in a while, he gets buff as shit.
He's
going to be, there's again another Santa action movie, which I feel like we literally just had one, but with J.K. Simmons and The Rock, and one of them or both of them are Santa. I don't know if there's like a Santa multiverse thing, but J.K. Simmons is like jacked as shit. My other favorite thing is that J.K. Simmons got super jacked to play Commissioner Gordon in the Snyderverse. Mm-hmm. And I don't think there was ever a scene. First off, I don't remember literally any scenes with Commissioner Gordon. But I definitely don't think there was a scene with Commissioner Gordon where anyone was like, dude's got muscles.
Yeah, he's like, we need Gordon's shirt off for this.
Yeah. I mean, when you're doing detective work, sometimes you just got to rip that baby off.
No, yeah, he was usually just looking confused next to the bat signal while several different heroes would show up and disappear randomly.
Yeah. Last call says, I know I missed it, but how did the Sam fight go? That went fine. I think we died twice. And once we kind of got down his pattern and everything, right. We were fine. Oh no, that's our dog?
Probably. Got Yamcha.
Yamcha. I love the shot, that meme of Yamcha like curled up in a little ball in his crater.
Alright, what is this about? Real casual slice of a bowl.
Sorry, John Lee. I totally spaced out when we started talking about Maya Rudolph and the M&Ms. The Kodak lottery with Sunny was that eventually a call would come where she talks about how Otacon became a ladies' man and brings women to the house and keeps it way too loud into the night.
Oh, wow.
Wait, does Sunny live with Otacon? That's, I don't like any of this. Also, look at this thing. What's going on? Wow. This large spider mech.
Yeah, this fight is insane.
Is this a Metal Gear? The top of it looks like a Metal Gear, but the bottom of it does not. No, top of it no longer looks like a Metal Gear.
What would you call this if it wasn't Metal Gear? We had Rex, because it was kind of dinosaur-like. We had Ray, because it was aquatic. Metal Gear Rax?
Yeah. I mean, like, is there a shortening of Arachnid?
Well, if it isn't
Metal Gear Widow? Six legs, not a spider. What's a six-legged spider?
Like
it's not a cricket? Literally not a spider. Like Cricky? Metal Gear Cricky? I'm
strong. Metal Gear Crick.
Metal Gear Crick. But your plan ends here. Why are we talking like that?
Idiot. Did we meet this man before this moment? You're not ending
our plan. You're I don't think so. Senator it's weird Armstrong. That they know each other. I mean, maybe he knows him because he's like a famous senator.
That is basically like, crap, what's his name? Mitch McConnell hopping out of a giant spider robot.
Buff Mitch McConnell. How did they?
Are they blaming him for this stuff?
You did kill all these people, didn't you? Then Marshall's plan is ruined. The hell it
is.
Look what they're saying. The story just went live, and already they're calling for blood.
The Actus of Evil. Isn't that from...
That was the post 9/11.
It was like World War II, right?
Yeah, no. There was the original. The Axis was they tried to Italy, bring Germany, okay. And Japan. And then George Bush said it was Iran, Iraq, and Afghanistan.
Yeah, he's trying to bring back the oldies.
The Patriots, they knew war was good for the economy. 4 years later, their legacy lingers on. The memes. They lost their great isms.
That's what I want to save too. The memes.
Welcome maxims for those with no faith, without guiding principles of their own. Give yourself up to the whole. No need to better yourself. You're American. You're number one. Then the only value left is dollar value. The economy. So we'll do whatever it takes to keep it humming along. Even war. Especially war.
Bullshit.
The Patriots planted the seed. We don't need them around to filter and foster their memes any longer. We're spreading them.
There are memes now.
Every American man, woman, and child. We're all sons of the Patriots now. We just need something to jumpstart the economy out of this funk. This recession has been stuck in since the fall of SOP.
And the military costs? Wasting billions is going to help the economy?
DMCs, arms manufacturers, job creators, Jack. All those workers spending money, paying taxes. Trust me, a little war can...
That is ridiculous, but this is not untrue.
No, I...
Like the back and forth that they're arguing right now.
Oh, relax, Jack. It's a war on terror. We're not out to kill civilians. Extremists, lawless gangs, madmen. Of course, that would have to include you. Wouldn't want any eyewitness reports complicating the message.
This is the future where Vince McMahon enters politics. Is it an ant? Is that what it is? Do ants have six legs?
No, they're so small. There's no way anyone's ever seen how many legs they have.
No one's ever counted the legs on an ant.
What's going on down there? Yeah, it looks ant-like. But then, yeah, I guess it's got, like, pincers. Oh, Metal Gear Excelsius? So I guess they did just name it.
Oh. Okay. I was late to that party. I was thinking about changing my weapon, that's why.
Conceptualization said, is it amusing or depressing that this seems less silly than when it first came out? Yeah.
Oh my god, that jump was so short. Oh, that was faster than the last one. I wonder if I can actually parry those guys and jump over them. Probably not. I think the blades are yellow for a reason.
You know, given how Kojima, every game he makes ends up predicting the future, maybe it's a good thing that he never made Silent Hills. Because what if it just would have been like, oh man, Kojima was right. Turns out there's demons in all of our hallways. Yeah, don't go to the bathroom at night because there's definitely like ghost women out there.
All of this. Get off.
Take off your shitty elbow armor. Geronimo Torres says, speaking of crabs, did anyone else hear the theory that everything eventually evolves into crabs?
I have heard that theory. I don't understand.
What does that mean?
I don't know. Something about evolution just turning everything into crab-like creatures.
So, like, crabs were just, like, regular-ass people a million years
ago? They're the perfect living entity.
What are you talking about? They're perfect. We toss them in hot water. We fucking boil them. They scream when they die. Hey, perfect. If they were perfect, they wouldn't be delicious.
If you were perfect, you'd taste like shit.
Jombly said you might want to save before a checkpoint coming up. Why? Also, we can't save in the middle of battle. That's illegal.
Did he just... What the hell just happened?
Oh, he's just, like, fucking flaming.
He, like, murdered shooting. His own,
Murdered his own little geckos.
Yeah.
This dude's a genuine asshole.
I picked up a BP, it said. But I don't see it.
What did you pick up?
The healing thingy. Oh, no. Hollow
no,
chip.
A BP
okay.
is a chip.
Yeah.
Rithbo says, guessing you're supposed to use those as medkits. What does that mean?
Shit.
Use what as medkits?
Yeah, use what as medkits?
Oh, slice them and take their spines. Oh, like the geckos could in theory be your medkits.
Oh, got it. That makes sense.
Okay, that's good. That's fine. Last boss. Get our shakies out.
Oh, I have a checkpoint.
Oh, nice.
I think.
Oh, yeah, 60%.
Yeah.
That's gonna be it. That's good boss design. Having to start a boss all the way from the beginning, if it's like several stages, no one wants that.
Unless it's a front call game. Then you welcome it.
That's true. Not everyone loves it. Game of the year. 12 million copies.
Oh, stop shooting at me.
Yeah, it's hard to get health from the geckos when you're getting fucking lasered.
Shooting at them. Yeah, those lasers coming in are a problem.
Yeah.
Also, I can't
move. Oh, yeah, Nine Seed said, I have no luck using geckos for health. I always get lasered by Armstrong.
Yeah, I'm not going to do that anymore.
What's the easiest way to... How do we... Is there, like, a way to buy medkits?
Oh, yeah, I'll just throw on this side. That works. Do not.
Fear the wrath of the USA.
Come on, new phase.
Thanks, Armstrong. It's really good. Is this just where we live now? He's just gonna keep doing this stomp?
Here we go.
Hopefully this will checkpoint us.
Be nice. Yeah, and it feels like at the checkpoints, if we die, it just takes us back there with 100% health. Peace first with a $2 donation. I believe most Japanese citizens fear that wrath. But it's true. No one wants to be stepped on. It's bad. Yeah, Green Venice. I've been noticing that, like, the music, like, the song will play instrumental, and then when you do cool shit, it'll kick the lyrics in.
Yeah.
And it's done that for most of the boss fights so far, which is very cool.
Remember when I said body slam an airplane? I'm in a giant mecha ant. Give me that.
Give
me my new
sword. Our weapon now. It's our new sword. Our new sword is your arm.
Just add it
your
to the thorax. Inventory.
Add it to the inventory. This seems excessive.
It's ridiculous, but I love it.
Oh, that's two buttons. Oh, one button several times.
Here we go. Big Zandatsu.
Oh my god. Where does it want us to Zandatsu?
All of it.
Is it just anywhere?
I like that it does take, like, he doesn't just swing it recklessly. It's like, I need some time for this one.
Reclaim says, oh my god, this is so stupid and so cool. what's up, Omni Slasher? Welcome. You didn't say it was cool. False, I said it was cool. And I think it's cool, so I just added that. I can read any chat out and just add it's cool at the end. It's called editorializing.
All that cut and I didn't get this pod.
Slippery little bastard.
Still smoking a stogie? No, he's done with the stogie. Time for this. Hell yeah. There's Mitch McConnell.
Those sumo lessons coming in handy. He's like bigger now, right? Like he was already big, but he's like even bigger.
Yeah, he got more buff.
Let's go. The hell are you thinking?
That bunch of weird veins sticking out.
Remember, I just body slammed a giant ant mecha and then despair they were short to charge me.
Played college ball.
Like, dude, you didn't need the robot. Ow. Using hockey from One Piece.
Oh, he says I played college ball, and Ryden makes fun of him for doing it at the Ivy League school. Dumb game.
Try University of Texas. Could have gone pro if I hadn't joined the Navy. I'm not one of those beltway pansies. I could break a president in two with my bare hands.
You could break any politician ever in two. You are so large.
Jesus.
Look, he punted you. The crowd's cheering.
It would be funny if Ryan was like, what were you, a kicker?
Yeah.
What the hell are you? Why don't you stick around and find out?
Alright, this man.
Omni Slasher said, are the controls for this game hard to figure out?
No.
There you go. You heard it here first.
Come on. Oh, you know what? That might be me. I'm trying to press the wrong buttons.
No, not hard at all. Fuck, I hit the wrong button.
Well, no, I didn't. I did not hit the wrong button.
Oh, he's just very angry.
He's just grabbing me. I didn't realize I died.
You just said, yeah, I think you entered that with very little health.
All right, we're 100 now.
Is this the first Metal Gear game to ever have you and another man fighting on top of a robot? No one's ever, they've never done that in any other Metal Gear game, right? That wasn't in one or two or four or five.
Yo, I'm in the corner right now. I was able to dodge it.
At least it's not knocking you off and having to climb back up like a Metal Gear 1.
Like, look, this man won't let me land!
Why is he being so angry?
See, that's weird, because I definitely dodged his assault, but he still grabbed me.
Geronimo Torres with a great question. Maybe it's a graphical glitch, but every time he's about to headbutt you, a filter goes on, and it looks like he's wearing blackface. I don't know if you noticed that, but I saw it several times, and I think, I'm assuming it's just lighting.
That. Like, that's his nanomachine thing. He's like hardening the parts of his body that he's hitting me with.
Oh, I didn't like that.
Which is essentially what hockey is in One Piece.
One Piece has hockey?
They have a power set that anyone can use. Or is there a man named Hockey? Okay. Like, you know how they have, like, the Devil Fruit system in One Piece?
Sure, sure.
There's an additional system that anyone can use if they train hard enough that lets them do weird stuff like harden parts of their body or harden something that they're holding on to.
Okay. Seems convenient.
It is very convenient. It helps you fight against the Devil Fruit users who turn into dumb shit like smoke and sand and water. Because you can't put hands on them unless you got the
hockey. You can't put hands on water?
Nope. I mean, you could put your hand on it, but the water will, you know, go around you. That was a nice counter riding. I like how Ryan is kind of a villain sometimes.
Yeah.
You're right about one thing. I do need capital and votes. Want to know why?
Why?
I have a dream.
What? You can't call out that one.
Every person in this nation will control their own destiny.
Well, that's nice.
A land of the truly free, damn it! A nation of action, not words, ruled by strength, not committee. Where the law
is gonna say it.
To suit the individual, not the other way around. Where power and justice are back where they belong, in the hands of the people.
I don't know what.
To be honest, all this sounds pretty good.
Does it? That sounds like a libertarian.
Libertarian? Oh no! Oh, yeah. The marketplace of ideas.
That I can get on board with.
I like trivia, though. I like fun facts.
Fun facts about Kim Kardashian?
What's coming up, Casey?
Ooh.
What is he gonna do?
We need to pull it out by the roots. Wipe the slate clean. Burn it down!
God damn.
You know what he's about to say, right?
And from the ashes, a new America will be born.
Not the nanomachines line, right?
No.
The weak will be purged. And the strongest will thrive. Free to live as they see fit. They'll make America great again!
What are you talking about?
You still don't get it. I'm using war as a business to get elected. So I can end war as a business. In my new America, people will die and kill for what they believe. Not for money, not for oil, not for what they're told is right. Every man will be free to fight his own wars.
Like, I can see why someone, especially someone who is somehow this strong, would champion the idea of look, as an individual, I want to be able to do what I want to do. And yeah. laws and such shouldn't be able to stop me.
Like, yeah, I get yeah. that. And he'd also be a huge Reagan fan.
But it's still very narrow-minded. So, like that's the whole purpose of libertarianism, is that it serves the individual, whereas we live in a society, as
yeah.
some crazy yeah, person yeah. once said in a comic book.
Well, yeah.
Try fighting for what you believe in sometime, Jack. Not for a company or a nation or for anyone else.
Maybe I was wrong about you.
Am I finally getting through?
Oh, let me help you out, buddy. Let me dust you off. Are you coming around, huh? You see my point?
I was wrong.
What if they just became allies? Right. That's how the game ends.
I love you.
That's insane.
Ah! Armbar.
Did he actually think like his speech won Raiden over?
Probably.
Damn, I'm a good politician.
Yeah, politicians are full of themselves.
Yeah, that is
give
true.
Give them enough coddling.
Yeah, really? they're surrounded by yes men. Did you see that guy's gap? That was crazy.
Yeah, they love stories like that. To be like, hey, you dirt poor pieces of shit, get like this guy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Try and shut me up. You'll fail like the others.
Dang, my health is low.
Oh no, why did you start us with 50%? That's so low. Oh no, now we have 2%.
Well, I'm barehanded.
What? Did he take our sword away? What's going on? Oh, this is one of those cutscene deaths. I see what's going on.
Got 0.1% life. Electric punch.
Oh, it didn't work.
Ugh. There's a reason I stopped using this. Where's he going? It's not effective.
It's not effective at all. Yeah, I do like that his health is going down like a tad bit with every punch.
Yeah, like it's not doing
like
zero
literally
damage.
8.1%.
But he's legit.
Why won't you die?
Ugh.
They harden in response to physical trauma. You can't hurt me, Jack.
Beast Marshal the $2 Dodo says it's half Trump and half Andrew Ryan from Bioshock. Yeah, pretty much. I could totally see him saying a man chooses, a slave obeys. As he punches the life out of Raiden.
Nine.
me doubting the whole thing. We'll leave it up to fate.
Blondie? He's not talking about Ryan, is he?
A duel to the death.
Best
man win.
I think so.
Sam.
Like, cause this man is definitely not blonde.
Ryan's blonde.
His hair is pure white.
Maybe he's colorblind.
He's, what did he say, colorblind? What?
Colorblind. Colorblind!
The lock on my blade will disable after a couple hours. What happens after that is up to you, Wolfie.
Huh. Even dead, that guy's a pain.
Oh, sorry, YouTube. For some reason, I only had top chat on this whole time. So, oh, because I have it open and fucking...
Oh, everyone is saying platinum blonde.
Ah, Wagga Wagga. Oh, I thought that was a platinum joke. Never mind.
No.
I retract
it
my Wagga Wagga.
Is, but I didn't realize, is that when people say platinum blonde, they refer to white hair?
Yeah.
Versus just a very light yellow hair?
Yeah.
Because
no,
I assume white hair is white hair. Like, you don't call old people platinum blonde.
No, I feel like platinum blonde has to be, is manufactured. White hair, there's like natural white hair.
Uh-huh.
You can't, like, dye your hair white. You dye your hair platinum blonde.
Was Raiden's son's hair also white? That's a
good boy. Oh, yeah. Remember that little shit? What is he up to?
Wait, no. Raiden was blonde, wasn't he?
Like, in Metal Gear Solid 2,
yeah,
he was.
Yeah, in 2, yeah. He was blonde. Yeah. You become an individual, Wolfie. Congrats. Don't you do it. Don't you hurt my dog.
Damn much.
No.
Oh!
I'm gonna John Wick your ass right now.
I said my sword was a tool of justice. Not used for vengeance. But now I'm not so sure. And besides,
this isn't my sword.
Isn't my sword.
Dun dun dun.
Who do you think would win in a fight? Armstrong or the Hulk?
Come on.
Probably the Hulk, but like Armstrong has a lot of self-confidence, whereas Bruce Banner has like, he really questions himself a lot, his abilities and everything.
I don't know, what the hell is that move?
What, there is so much happening right now.
I don't like that I picked up this cool shiny new sword and he's still like, kind of just
fucking
having stuff bouncing off me, yeah.
Like, I thought this sword was going to be like an instant win kind of thing.
What the hell was that?
I don't like how they spell damn it with an N. How do you spell damn it?
With two M's.
Yeah, same. How do you spell whoa?
Whoa? Oh.
Yeah, like whoa.
W-H-O-A?
Okay, I do W-O-A-H. Chat, how do you spell whoa? Sound off in the comments below.
I watched a super interesting video about slang and how brands kill slang earlier today.
And how what? Post
brands.
What?
Like,
oh, okay.
Like how social media brands will like try to adopt slang for
purposes.
And that's essentially the death knell in whatever that slang is in most cases.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Once it reaches a certain point.
It was a real, like, with a PhD linguist kind of breaking it down. Super interesting stuff. But one point that she made that I hadn't considered, but kind of realized at one point, was that the internet age and the fact that brands trying to connect with people via social media is the reason why certain slang words started being written down for the first time.
Yeah.
Because like growing up, I would use the word wallin', like wallin' out.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh shit, okay.
But you never had to write it.
Yeah, I never had to write it. But then there came a time where wallin' out started showing up on the internet.
Yeah.
And there were like multiple different ways people would write it.
Yeah, because they're like, oh, this is something that's only been like passed down verbally.
Yeah, so like that happened in my lifetime, the thing that she was explaining. But the thing that always angered me is that no matter how someone wrote it on the internet, it was never what Nick Cannon's show was called, which is Wild and Out. It was never that.
Yeah.
But somehow that was what was landed on. Because clearly Nick Cannon wanted that show to be called Wild and Out. Because that's what people say. Oh, they're Wild and Out. But Wild and Out, not a thing. But somehow that's what they had to name that show.
Which is really funny. Yeah, I wonder if it was like a URL thing or like we need like a some sort of proper spelling for a brand. Simple Simon says, what do you think the first word is before out? I say Wylin, like W-Y-L-I-N apostrophe, I think. Wylin? I don't think I put a D in Wylin.
Yeah, like the Y pronunciation that I hear, like that sounds wrong to me. Like I say Wylin.
Wylin.
Yeah.
Oh, is that, do you think that's like a...
It could be regional.
A regional thing, yeah.
So whenever I spelled it, I would do like W-H-A-L-I-N.
I don't think when the first time I saw it, like written down, there was the Nick Cannon thing. There was Kid Cudi or Big Sean had a song, Wildin' Cause I'm Young. I think it was on one of those like Cruel Summer things, the like Kanye mixtape things.
Ouch.
Oh, Wildin' Cause I'm Young was on Kid Cudi's second album. You don't like Kid Cudi, right?
Oh, I love Kid Cudi, but he's been known to make some stinkers in my opinion.
Okay.
He has whole albums.
Oh yeah,
because
you liked what was it called? Intergalactic.
Intergalactic, yeah. And the album for Intergalactic is really good. Like I still listen to that regularly.
Nice. Ready or not, Jack. Facel ruins everything. Says, "Don't think of this as a Dark Souls boss. Don't fight greedy, or else you're gonna get punished." Apparently, this guy is the like, he's the toughykins.
He has lots of range on those attacks.
Yeah. Deccan Jaxter said, "You can also upgrade Sam's sword." Wait, like right now?
Yeah, like in the middle of this fight. Like, this isn't too crazy. I just need to pay attention more.
We're also not be discussing the linguistic origins of...
Oh, I gotta do this a specific way.
Okay. Hell yeah.
Oh, there's another one! Shit!
You didn't expect two of them! I don't like that...
Got him.
What?
Yes. Just caught and flung this man. Hilarious, bro.
Deck and Jester said from Codec. Apparently, we can upgrade from the Codec. Also, save after you collect those healing items. Oh, so maybe we save now?
Yeah, I got one. There's other
or
ones.
We'll see. Four. Yeah. Oh, there's a. I think there's one on the ground, but it's like in no man's land.
Yeah, I'm trying to get to it.
That's fine. We might be able to. Do the. We're learning.
Save now.
Might be able to do a cleaner fight.
How do I save? Oh, I gotta call.
Codec probably call. Yeah.
Was it Courtney?
So wait, can we call someone to? Wait, who's our save person? They should have like what they fucking
it's Courtney,
do underneath
right?
there.
There's no other way. I understand that now. You've got to stop him. You've got.
Wait, were you
to
against
him.
Me killing him at some point?
You have to, Raiden. You have to kill him.
What color is my shirt? Oh, maybe customize allows you to upgrade stuff. That's like a number at the bottom.
Makes some sense.
Can you just like pop into a VR mission right now? Like Ryan just like kind of like fugues out.
He just starts playing a video game in real time in his brain. Yeah, I had no idea.
We could have been doing this the whole time.
Super accessible.
Oh my god!
At all times.
So you should definitely use all of your money right now.
Foxblade. Still can't
use also, that. You should use all your money and then probably save again because so you don't have to do it
over
every time.
How do I upgrade Sam's sword? Or is my main weapon now Sam's sword? because this still says high frequency blade.
Oh, yeah, that's a good question. Wait, who said you could upgrade?
Wait, Dice put a ton of messages in there, but
You can't upgrade Sam's sword until you beat the game. My bad. Okay. Well, no problem. Fair. So I mean, maybe use it on life and fuel cells?
What would I have? Endurance? Sure. Let's endure.
Well, wait, that was one.
I can no longer.
That was money well spent. That's fine. We got life. Life's good.
I just need to be able to heal a bunch. Like, I don't feel like
that's
I'm
fine.
Doing
that's fine.
No
we'll
damage
Lucy.
Or anything.
We'll get Lucy. We're fine.
Oh no, this started over!
What do you mean started over?
This is... Like, I have full health. And this is the beginning... Like, he has full health. This is how the fight starts.
We got... Was this supposed to call Courtney?
Probably.
We have a healing item now. That's good.
We do.
And that's a plus. That's a plus.
So when it,
and we probably wouldn't have made it through on that run anyway. So I guess like a clean run. Whose fault? Is this Courtney's fault? Guys, we learned something else about Courtney. She fucking sucks. She fucking sends us back at the beginning of the fight. Mei-Ling would never do that to us. Let me say it perfectly clear right now. Mei-Ling would have saved, would have told us a fact about a movie she watched the night before.
Maybe that's supposed to happen. In. Oh my god. Damn, what way to intercept that freaking elbow drop.
I feel like that there should have been like a Mortal Kombat X-ray thing. Like, you kick his ribs.
How did that hit? I was mid-flippy-flip.
Mid-flippy-flip.
Away from him.
Dumbly said Mei-Ling would have never done that because you never called her.
That's true.
Also true.
Wait, can I just pick the sword back up?
Paul Sai says he reminds me of an Elden Ring boss. Yeah, he reminds me of Horaloo. Horaloo is Miyazaki. Again, Miyazaki, no original ideas ever. He played this boss fight and he just told some people, yeah, make this man, but make him chieftain of the Badlands. It's fine. Classic, Michael. Oh, Dice, that was really good. I didn't notice that. The lyrics cut out when you didn't have your sword in your hand, and then picked back up when you grabbed it. Look, you're crushing now.
Come on.
Oh, no. Oh, he's back.
Yeah, because this was actually where we picked up all the stuff and have to save it.
Yeah.
We were just back at the start.
Should we call Courtney again and see what's up?
Oh, did they give me another one?
Nice. Ah!
Again.
Jack Jaxter said, when you don't have your sword and you try to dodge, you do the Metal Gear Solid 2 flip. Does he hold his privates?
That's funny.
He doesn't want anyone to see his yunks.
That's a torch punch. Counter the shit out this man.
Hell yeah. Flip! Stop it! You do too many flips!
I don't know what that
was. Got all sorts of goodies now.
Okay, we
got paste them
these
up.
Bad boys.
He still said save, but I don't trust saving now. So
yeah, it'll start the fight over with these three things.
Yeah, unless it was because of the upgrade.
Maybe.
Also, damn, those attacks take a lot out of you. Like, two or three attacks took 75% out of you. What was he doing?
More chucks.
Oh, did you just throw more shit at you? We could do this. This is easy. Okay, Dice said it was because we went to customize. It's fine. We'll be fine. Holy shit. I don't need any of this. Boom. Roasty toasty.
We've got three storage dealers right now. He's got 71 health.
Everyone says saving is fine right now. that it was because we customized, that's why it restarted. So if you want to save, you can create a little checkpoint right now. Several people have said that, and I trust them.
Look, I have full health. I don't want to save.
You really... I like the confidence.
Oh, I picked the wrong button!
Whoa!
Ryan's dead. That's it. Game over.
I think you need to dodge those, because each of those takes like 20% off your health.
20%?
What's everything green?
Is he healing?
He's healing. Time stone. He's got the time stone. He's healing. Stop him from healing. Chat, how are we stopping from healing? What do we do? Tell him to stop.
Shit, and Chat, he's countering every time.
Blade mode is back. Blade mode is back.
Oh, okay,
that's his back.
It's not his back at all.
It was the opposite of his back. Okay, well, at the very least, it stopped him from healing, so. Oh, he got it. Yeah, quite a bit. He's got like all. He's got several powers. Oh, this dude's just Thanos. That's what he is. He's just like beefy Josh Brolin Thanos. Yeah, we're aware, Dice. You don't need to tell us that. I know we healed a lot.
He healed like more than his starting health.
He healed a lot. That was a lot of health. We didn't know what was going on.
Don't worry, guys. We'll get there. We got time to burn.
We got time. This is the last fight of the game.
Extra hits. Oh yeah, that took a lot.
Yeah, every other enemy, you're not taking damage, but like it takes still like 20% damage every time you block one of those. That's why you have zero now. Or zero healing items. So, Simon, he healed. We didn't want him to heal. He fucking healed. We didn't know what to do. Jumbly says, Marty, did you beat this on baby mode back in the day? Yes, I did, Jumbly.
Oh, okay. I'm trying to dodge around back, but it swings a sword at the same time. Also, why can't I see him?
He's healing right now. You gotta do something.
That's not the right way.
Oh, there we are.
But he turned around. Why?
At the very least, he stopped healing.
Yeah, maybe just blade mode, period, is the way. But then he just starts doing it again, and I get hurt.
How does A-hole stop healing?
Yeah, he's tripping right now. I don't like that. What's wrong? He just punched me in the face.
He did punch you in the face. He punched you right in the head.
So start it with the one. What the? Okay.
Apparently, we just weren't hitting the exact square we needed to hit for the back hits when he's healing.
Gotcha.
There was like a very small hitbox for the... What's it called? Zendatsu? Zendatsu.
Yeah, that was early. Like, how far do I need to be to get away from that?
Way blast radius. He just got so many different powers.
Hey, right. Hello.
Oh! Didn't expect that. What do you... So, obviously, like, Platinum's made some anime games in the past. Like, they did, I don't know, is... Last Airbender, you don't call it. Do you call it anime? No.
Yeah, not really.
Avatar and Korra? No. Yeah,
definitely inspired. Sure.
I know you, you've written in the past about how you sort of have a low tolerance for a lot of anime games. Do you think there's a specific property that Platinum could, like, if Platinum put its A team, like, and really gave it the old college try, do you think there's an anime that they could make, like, a really cool combat system out of?
I'm trying to think. I mean, because most games, like, most animes have really cool combat, period. So, like, kind of just any popular anime, I think Platinum would be able to do justice if they, you know, tried.
Yeah.
But I can't think of an anime that I think...
Like, I keep watching the sword stuff, and I'm like, what's, like... Is Demon Slayer's, like, the...
Yeah, Demon Slayer
thing I think of when I think of, like, Raiden's sword. Oh, there you go. Hell yeah. Get fucked.
Also, he's way over.
Jesus, what is happening? That's so many hits. Also, I feel like he spit out a shit ton more. Oh, maybe we just haven't hit a certain point yet. Because we got up to 5 health boxes at one point, and we only got 2 now.
Yeah. I think it followed, yeah, the second time he threw stuff at us.
Oh, yeah,
stuff on the
floor. Oh, yeah, right, I see him right there. Ah. Yeah. Shashank says Bleach. Is Bleach all sword combat?
It is, but Bleach's sword combat doesn't look anywhere near as good as Demon Slayer.
Oh, really? Demon Slayer's looks very good.
Oh, it's amazing.
Alex K, Chainsaw Man. Yeah, I imagine someone's gonna... I have to imagine a Chainsaw Man game will probably be announced this year. Hopefully it's a good one and not a cash-in.
Yo, some rib broke.
George Lucas said, how about Berserk? No, Miyazaki would not allow anyone to make a Berserk game other than Miyazaki. Also, the problem is you'd make a Berserk game and then a bunch of people would play it not knowing the anime or the manga and be like, they stole this from the Souls games. And someone would have to break it to them that Miyazaki stole it from that.
Dude, you're not gonna let me what get the sword back.
Just, will you stop?
I want to go to where the sword
is. The fire there forever?
Yeah, it's just stuck there. Here we go.
Shit. That was a long time. Blech. We don't talk about the Berserk Dynasty Warriors game. None of the Berserk games are good. Simple Simon with a $2 donation says, if nothing else, we should run out of blood soon. I think that's safe to say. Yeah.
Yeah, he's bleeding a lot.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I have to just straight run away from him and start that up.
Shashank, I haven't played any of the Berserk games, but I watched a couple of video essays on them, and I heard the Musou one wasn't super highly regarded by fans. Not that, like, a lot of the games were highly regarded as fans. Oh, he's ready. He's getting buffos. Oh, shit. This last time.
Oh, there's more.
Oh, a fourth! A fifth! Oh, shit, he's only at point one! That being said, Raiden was at point one and his dog came through for him, so who knows what happens with this man.
Congress can have a vote. And then Armstrong's gonna win.
He's getting more health. What is he doing? Why is he still alive? I don't like that they gave us more health right now, because it makes me think the fight's not over.
Yeah, F you. I want to take that arm. Oh, there it is.
Arm, yeah! Oh my god, all these fucking punches. No punches here.
Oh, How's that? You like that?
Fuck it.
Right.
Dang. Ooh, baby. Gotta aim that perfectly. Oh, we gotta hit that multiple times.
Oh my god. There's so many things we're cutting.
Hey, I want your nanomachines, son.
You don't want that guy's nanomachines.
I mean, they look pretty strong.
Server-ass nanomachines.
Like, it was the nanomachines that
changed his points of view.
Your dream dies with you. Oh, maybe not. You've guaranteed the status quo will go on for a while longer, at least. War will continue as an institution, as an industry. Men will fight for reasons they don't understand.
Beautiful.
Causes they don't believe in. But at least I'll leave a worthy successor.
You ain't talking about me, fam.
You, Jack.
You're now the senator of Colorado.
That is just in the Colorado Charter. Like, should someone murder the senator, the sitting senator, in active combat?
And if it costs a few lives, so be it.
I'll give you a big scratch.
Ew.
Eat it. Oh, that was good. Yeah. I really have to pee. I'm just gonna go at an inopportune time.
Deep inside.
Kindred spirits. So we'll listen to some ending cutscene while Marty relieves himself. That's a nice shot. Bravo. Time 21 minutes. Not bad. After 7. Monies. High frequency Muramasa blade. There we go. So this is still happening, like the whole, oh, there are terrorists in Pakistan, send American troops. Raiden's actions didn't necessarily prevent any of that. Hella pizza in this game.
For the last time, let it go, Courtney. At least Armstrong will never be president.
Because we killed him.
We did it. I'm proud of us. We killed the man who would be president. Wait, so do we know what color the shirt is? Does her shirt look blue or white?
That's white. That looks white to me.
Okay.
And we're sure this isn't child labor?
The older children can work now, the rest when they come of age.
Also, I feel like if you're ever in a scenario and you have to say, are you, and we're sure this isn't child labor, like, that's like If you're in that clarification zone, it's already kind of worrisome. The one thing about this game, these dudes aren't nearly as cool.
Yeah, they're all, as all the other crews. Boring and uninteresting.
Yeah.
Like Naomi, who freaking quadruple centuple crosses.
Yeah. Across the None of them series. Have that Drebin energy to them.
Like Platinum did a fantastic job making enemies to coincide with Kojima's Raiden. But yeah, like the sidekicks are, they leave a little something to be desired.
Most of the games are pretty good, like I don't know, Kojima's like good at making like weird buds for your character.
Speaking of recent events, how's our new recruit working out?
The Green Beanie says, Signet is my boy.
Oh, it's the kid.
Oh, they gave him a bionic arm.
Yeah.
Wait, why? His arm was his arm like messed up?
Did he lose an arm?
I don't remember that. Or is he just on his path to trying to get like Raiden? Like I saved up. This is my first upgrade.
Jesus.
Why does this dog have pain receptors?
On its tail, yeah. Oh, Raiden cut the arm off. He had to cut through the kid's arm to slice the scientist guy. Remember the guy was like, I'll kill the kid. Right.
And the kid was like, you okay with this? He's like, sure.
Yeah.
He probably didn't know Raiden was going to cut his arm, though.
No, he thought he was like, oh, yeah, you'll get a finger, right? You're like, nick me in the cheek. Geronimo Torres with a $2 donation said, would you get cyborg enhancements if you could? Yeah, sure.
It depends on the society we live in and like what I'm dealing with at that moment in time.
Okay.
I feel like a lot of factors would go into a decision like that. Like, I wouldn't get it for fun.
Okay. Mine was going to be for fun.
Because I think about Ghost in the Shell and how they frame the whole like, cyberization thing. Because the first thing is your brain. Like, you cyberize your brain so you can basically connect to infrastructure. And that's kind of the same thing as back in the day when you were like, oh, let's get a computer and the internet versus not having it. Like, you kind of need it for the way society is going.
Yeah. I mean, like, some of that stuff already exists. Like, I don't know, my mom's got a pacemaker. That's like a cyber heart.
Yeah. That is, that's practically the same thing.
But she did not choose that. That was like, you can either die or
that's get this. That's how it starts. Like, people who lose limbs and functionality, like, they can get machine implants that restore that functionality.
Sure.
But then because technology advances, like, that stuff ends up being better than the flesh and bone version.
Yeah. So why and not I imagine just if you... upgrade? Yeah, if you were to, like, if you were either born or you lost an arm or a leg or, you know, if you wanted a limb.
Simple Simon says, so Casey's trying to be Section 9, Marty's going Leisure Suit Larry.
It's weird that the game didn't end with, it just ended with Sonny and Boy, who's the
Like, they didn't check in with Raiden or anything. Well, maybe there's a post-credits dealio. Yeah,
it's true.
But yeah, that was great overall. Not super long.
No.
And also not super challenging. Like, it's kind of like... Yeah. It what's the word? It kind of carts you along, the missions,
sure.
I feel like.
Yeah.
It's not like other action games like... well, I've only played DMC, so I don't want to say the Devil May Cry series, but it's not like DMC or Sekiro or any FromSoft game where it's like, hey, here's a stopping point where you need to learn about this game.
You
need to get real familiar with the mechanics and what this boss has to offer because you're going to be here a while, right?
This is
more like, are you not having enough fun? Well, we'll checkpoint you once you reach this section and then, you know, just cut a bunch. Which is fun.
And its bosses with like the pattern memorization felt more traditional to me than like some of the Metal Gear bosses were just like weird. And even by the time we get to the end of them, it would be like, well, I'm just glad that's done.
Yeah, honestly.
Whereas every one of these bosses, I'm like, oh, if you went through this game again, like you could shave probably like 3 hours off your time or whatever. Yeah.
Like
Beastmarsh with a $2 donation said, "The older you are, the more likely you are to agree." I don't know what that's in reference to.
What?
I don't know. Oh, maybe the cybernetic thing. The older you get, the more likely you would want to
trade out. But probably.
Yeah.
I don't know, I'm pretty old. I just turned 36 today.
Is today your birthday?
Today is my birthday. Yes.
What? We did the whole Jesse birthday thing, and you never brought it up.
No, we talked about it on that stream. That Jesse and I do have very close birthdays, and his birthday was Monday. I was like, "Oh, that's neat." Oh, wait, my birthday is Thursday, so I'll be on stream during my birthday.
I blame.
This is a happy birthday balloon literally behind me. Like,
I blame. I didn't know what that was. I thought that was like a.
My fiance got that for me when I brought my.
You did a great colonoscopy. Great, no polyps. Well done. A lot of people wishing you a happy birthday. Thank Paul Sai is wishing me a happy birthday, which I appreciate.
And you know what? Everyone, happy birthday. Happy birthdays. Just give yourself an extra age. Who gives a shit?
Happy birthdays all around. King Dead with a $2 donation. Happy birthday, kiddo.
Thank you.
King Dead 42, born in 1942. King Dead is our oldest user at 81 years old. True Mando with a highlighted message said, "This might be the best series you've done yet. This was so much fun to watch. Thank you for your work." Our pleasure. You. This was great. Yeah, it was a blast going through this. It's crazy that we've only gone through two series, but we've gone through like two full series.
Yeah, like Metal Gear has a lot of games in them.
Metal Gear has a lot of games. Yeah, Dead Space went by much quicker.
I'm glad, because not that I dislike gameplay in Metal Gear. I very much liked it, but
yeah.
This is more so like my bread and butter. Like,
sure,
like hack and slashy, action-y, like fast-paced, whatever. Like, that's what brings me the most joy when I play video games.
Yeah.
So, like, I wouldn't mind going through a full series of a bunch of one of these. So
yeah, seriously.
If that comes up at some point, I'd be down for it. I'm also a first-person shooter fan. So we'll be starting Half-Life next week. Like, are we taking a break between?
It's your call. I'm down to start next week.
I'm pretty sure I'm good to go.
I'm gonna be here. Yeah,
I just got to get the game from somewhere. And we are doing the we're starting with the remade version.
No, we're gonna be starting with original. Well, let me do a little bit of research. But it sounds like the consensus was play the original Half-Life.
Uh-huh.
But there are some version that could be easier to play or will be better easier to run with your computer.
Yeah, like because remember I do need to stream this, so if you give me like a super wonky thing, it like it just may not function.
And also don't give us a do this version and download these 10 mods and then load it in this fucking bootstrap. I don't even know what a bootstrap is.
Yeah, like, what's the John easiest thing I can just put on the PC and then get OBS to look at
and then stream it. But then yeah, a lot of people have said play original Half-Life, not Half-Life Source. For some reason, I don't know what the difference between those two are, but everyone says do not play whatever Source is, play the original Half-Life. I imagine it's a Steam game, so that'll be like easy.
Like Valve must have made a version that is just current on Steam today, right?
And once we get past the first Half-Life, all the other ones you can just download on Xbox. It's fine. Like, you just download the orange box, and that's got all the Half-Life 2 games and Portal, and then it'll be fine.
Also, some folks were talking about playing it on a gamepad. There is controller support for the first one, right?
I assume so. Chat? Yes, that would be insane, right?
I don't know.
Granted, I could see Gabe Newell doing some like crazy shit, being like, nope. Speaking of libertarians, Gabe Newell comes out. Senator Armstrong Newell.
Valve machine, son.
Everyone's saying it was PC only. We know it was PC only, but like, you can use a controller, right?
Yeah.
No, everyone's saying I don't think so.
Shit. I mean, I can use a mouse and keyboard for FPS, especially one that isn't like super, like it's an older game, so I don't think there's like a ton of buttons I have to press for it, I don't think.
No.
But that's gonna be a pain in the ass, honestly.
That's insane.
I couldn't just like map a thing to it.
I mean, we could play Black Mesa, right? Isn't the way to get through this is to play Black Mesa, the thing that came out a few years ago that has.
But to be fair, like, I do kind of want to experience the OG one. Okay, here we go. We got our end credit scene.
Herr Doctor's research and staffing service certainly help.
I hear World Marshal's looking for a buyer.
Well, you cost them a lot of money, huh? Not to mention killing their funding, literally. The breathtaking program is finished, but the larger company is not, I'm afraid. Someone will buy them. PMCs are in demand once again.
Yeah. Fighting for reasons they don't understand. Causes they don't believe in.
Beg pardon?
No.
He's reciting Armstrong's rhetoric.
Ooh. So, your mind is made? You will not come back.
Sorry, Boris.
I understand. But then, what will you do?
What will you do? Just murder random cyborgs? I don't.
Yeah, but he looks a little more human now.
I got my own war to fight.
I think they really thought that Konami wouldn't go to shit and Kojima would still be there and they'd be able to make a sequel to this like 3 years
later. Yeah, like, they definitely left this wide open for him to just do whatever.
This feels like when this title came up, a 2 should have appeared, and then like a Raiden will return and Revengeance 2. How many beheadings? 12 beheadings. That's a good amount of beheadings.
Fair number of beheadings.
What do you think? Only one? Oh no, 1-1, left leg to right leg. Passing rate. Ooh, what? Mr. 1%.
Complete normal higher difficulty while earning 300,000.
Mr. 1% because you made a lot of money.
300,000 though? I don't know if that qualifies. Difficulty.
That was only like 10 health. Congrats, you got Akabugbugka.
So we were actually pretty close to time.
That was pretty spot on.
Yeah.
That was pretty spot on. Yeah.
So good stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, what a journey, starting with Metal Gear Solid 1 on the PC, which was an ordeal. but then
it was funny in retrospect.
it was pretty funny in retrospect. You had to
jump through and play through that.
Yeah. And then 2 and 3, which not an ordeal. 4, a minor ordeal, just because we had to dig that old, that dusty old console.
The only problem, I mean, that stuff was a headache in the beginning, but the only issue after that was the stupid controllers. Like, I couldn't get an actual PS3 controller, and all the replacements controlled it weird. Like, just that left stick felt a little weird.
Yeah.
But we got through it.
It did seem like 4 is the game that, like, was the most forgiving mechanically, and I guess that's because I don't know, as gave you the most control.
Yeah, you could just aim and shoot people.
Yeah.
Like none of the games before that let you like actually just aim and shoot. Like I could move and aim my gun at the same time.
Yeah.
That's so freeing in a way that you.
And we did luck out. Whatever happened when we went through that European section of 4, I appreciated because
they no, it was because I don't know if the mask or something, right? They
said, oh yeah,
I was wearing like a disguise that helped.
The disguise that was it. Yeah.
Stuff.
Yeah, it was great. And then Ground Zeroes, then this. So we did it. We did quite a bit of Metal Gear.
Remember that foray into Survive.
No, I blocked that and the dinosaur game with Nick out of my mind. both of those I brought up in therapy, and we don't talk about them anymore. So I don't know if it's compartmentalizing, but yeah.
But yeah,
And so next week we'll be starting our Half-Life journey, probably on the original Half-Life, maybe on Black Mesa. I'm gonna be honest. What would you rather do? Original on mouse and keyboard or remake on controller?
Like I want to play the original so that once I do get to Black Mesa, I can kind of like with the Dead Space thing, I can kind of see like, oh, this is that. This is, you know, this has changed for the better or whatever. I want to see what was going on in the first game because that game is classic, right?
Yeah.
So I do want to play it. If I have to play with mouse and keyboard, fine. But I'm going to try a workaround. I'm going to see how I can get the controller.
It's shocking to me. No one's made a mod for that for... controller.
Like it must exist? And if not, can't I just force it to? Like, I can't just map the controls to the controller? I feel like that was a thing you could do back in the day.
Everyone keeps saying Yahtzee's gonna be hurt. No. If we play the original Half-Life, Yahtzee can't say a fucking thing about how we play it. If we say, okay, we're gonna play the original game, if we're using a controller, he has to shut up and keep writing his book. He doesn't get to say anything else. We'll figure it out. Yeah.
Not asking y'all will play Metal Gear Solid 5, right?
No, that is not, because the plan, Metal Gear Solid 5 would be a tough streamy game for full. Because we played all these games full. We have Casey's done no time in between them. But we'll see. With after Half-Life, you know, we talked about maybe revisiting Dead Space, you know, to sort of cap off our Dead Space replay, and maybe we'd revisit Metal Gear Solid 5, see what's going on.
Maybe a one-off Metal Gear Solid stream. Like, I might still have a save where I'm, like, halfway through that game. Because, like, I have played Metal Gear Solid 5, like, up to the Africa map. Where I did maybe two or three missions and was like, I think I've had enough Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yeah.
Like, not because I didn't like it. I was just, I played a lot of that game and I kind of was just moving on to something else and just never went back.
Yeah. And who knows, maybe Nick's newfound love for Death Stranding will make you want to go on that.
I kind of want to try that too.
Walking in Piston Journey.
Now that I think it'd be fun. For $0, I might check it out.
Yeah. Thanks, Epic.
Thank you, Epic.
But
yeah, what do you have coming up this week, Marty, that you want to let the folks know about?
We got no streams tomorrow. Zero streams. None. You're not allowed to open up YouTube or Twitch at all tomorrow. It's a day of silence for both of them. No streams for The Escapist. And then I'm going to be out of town most of the weekend. Oh, also no game night, I found out. No game night, because so many of us are going to be gone.
Oh, okay. I thought it was just me.
No game night. I'm also going to be gone, and Frost is also going to be gone. And there's a lot of people gone. So no game night. However, Frost is going to be gone, so maybe there's not a wish list either. Ooh. I don't know what's going on. I do know on Sunday, Amy's going to be playing Hi-Fi Rush.
Okay, cool.
For newly released. And just check out, obviously, in case I'll bring it up, but Adventurous and I will be going live to the public this season finale on Saturday. That is a huge labor of love from so many people around here, and the response so far has been incredible.
It's so good.
And I mean, you guys know your incredible funding and donations helped us reach our goal to do Adventures Night Season 3 in Milwaukee in T-minus 2 months, which will be very exciting. So we're thrilled for that. And then check out the website. The website, we have so many great written features going up. I wrote about Hi-Fi Rush. I also recently wrote about Dokapon Kingdom and Persona 4. So check out the site. We've got a lot of great shit going on. What about you, Casey? What do you got?
As for me, I should have 3MR dropping soonish. Not sure exactly sure when, but at some point, check it out. Check my latest podcast over on my Twitch channel, Sigma Gears 9. You can also search for it on podcast services. Just search for The Sigma Show. It should pop right up. I'm getting close to 100 episodes. So I don't know if I'm gonna do something special for the 100th one, but we'll see. Keep an eye on the happenings over there. But outside of that, I don't know. I've written a couple of things on the site, so just check the site. For the cartoon recommendations I wrote so a little while back, as well as that 90s show full season review.
Hell yeah!
For the Netflix series. But yeah, I guess we're taking a little bit of a break going into the weekend, but we'll be back start next week.
Yeah, no worry. And Amy will be back on Sunday.
Sunday, right.
Don't you worry.
Also, I'll be back on Sunday for my podcast. So Sunday morning, I should be on.
There you go. Also, you can it's Friday, go to the movies. Go support James Cameron.
Go watch Puss in Boots. Do not go and watch that Blue Cat movie. Watch the Orange Cat movie.
Hey, just hit a fifth best biggest movie of all time, past Infinity War. So
what are we doing?
Get fucked, Tony Stark.
Society. Maybe Senator Armstrong was right. But thanks, everybody. This was super fun. We'll see you next week.
Bye, everybody.
And for the last time, sadly, take some snake jazz. Take some snake jazz home with you.
Rest in peace, snake jazz.
Hold on, I gotta change the... the art before I switch over. There we go. See you guys later. Bye.
Snake jazz.